Hi guys, Coach Danielle here. We are going to do about a 40-minute lift session right now. It's kind of similar to what we usually do in class with the stations, but of course we won't be rotating. We'll have two exercises that you'll be supersetting per station. Each exercise will be about 30 seconds each, with about 10 to 15 seconds transition time. We'll see. And we'll do about 6 minutes per station, all right? I'll post the warm-up video separately, so please make sure you warm up the muscles, warm up the body beforehand, 5 to 10 minutes. All right, grab your weights, your dumbbells. If you have a kettlebell, you could grab that too, but you don't have to. As long as you have two dumbbells, you're good. All right, let's do it. So you're gonna start off with pop squat. Grab two dumbbells, roll the shoulders down and back. If you have a kettlebell, you can use it too. I will demonstrate with both. Legs are going to be a little bit wider than hip width apart. Pop the chest, shoulders down and back. Did I say toes turned out? If I didn't, go ahead and turn out the toes a little bit. And we're just going to lower the weights in between the legs and then come up into high row or upright row and squat again. And keep it going. So that's 30 seconds here. I didn't start my timer. But I got it now. Don't forget to breathe. I'm a little bit sore from yesterday's class. Only go down as low as you can comfortably. And rest. All right, shake it out. Our second exercise of this station are renegade rows plus one frog jump. So your renegade rows, you want two dumbbells or one. You're gonna be in your high plank position, and I'm gonna go ahead and start the clock while I demonstrate, okay? But you're gonna be in your high plank position, and time starts now. Driving one elbow back at a time, keeping it nice and close to that side body, squeezing around the spine, trying to keep the hips square here. Once you do six, you have the option to do a little frog jump forward and then back. And then you'll do six again. One, two, three. And again, you can, actually I didn't even tell you yet, but you can drop it to your knees if you need to. If you have only one dumbbell, you can do it this way. Alright, after you do your six, option to do a little frog hop, then back into that renegade row. And rest. Woo! Good job. This is Abby, my daughter. Say hi.
Hi.
Okay, now we're gonna repeat those two. So standing back up, getting ready for pop squats. Alright. Time's gonna start in three, two, let's go. So legs out wide, squat. Squat, 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 squat. Keep it going. You squatting with me? If it's too hard to do the little pop part, you could do one weight. Up to you. Or you could eliminate the weight altogether. Keep it going. We have about, actually we're done. And rest. Going back to the mat. Renegade rows coming up with that frog jump, all right? Deep breath in. Get in that high plank position or down on the knees. And go. One, two. This is how it looks from the knees. Three. Try not to move those hips, okay? Four, five, six. Option to do that little frog jump forward and back. One, two, three, and time is up. Rest. Woo! Good job. We're gonna repeat those two one more time. One more round. All right. Oh, I'm feeling warm now. So get ready. Grab that weight. We're going back into pop squats. All right. One or two weights up to you. Legs out wide, toes turned out, and squat. 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 Again, you can make it an upright row if you want, or you could just pull it up. It's kind of like an upright row anyway. Try not to let that head or chest fall forward. Stay nice and tall with that upper body. And rest. And finishing off our first station with our Renegade Rows and Frog Jump. Here we go. Time starts now. One, two, three, good. Four, five, six, good. Hitting that back, frog jump, and back. Belly button to spine. As we're drawing in nice and tight here. Don't forget to breathe. 5 seconds left. Four, three, two, one. Rest. Woo, good. Made it through round one, station one. So hydrate if you need to, all right? We're moving on to number two. Kneeling squats and chest press, all right? So you need two dumbbells for both of those. Kneeling squats, you can hold a heavy weight here or two weights right here at your chest. You're gonna start on your knees, abs tight. 30 seconds starts now. You're gonna step forward with one leg, forward with the other one, making sure they're about hip width apart. Staying low, that's your squat. Then knee back, opposite side forward this time. And keep it going. If you have bad knees or something, what you can do instead is just do basic squats with the dumbbell at your chest, or you can set the dumbbell on the ground, up to you. All right, and rest. Good, so those are your kneeling squats. We're moving on to chest press. So you need two weights. I'm gonna show you a couple options. If you have a big exercise ball like I have back here, you can use that as well. Add a little unstable environment to incorporate the core, up to you, or if you have like a bench or something, you can use that, your Bosu. I'll show you from the floor first. Then you're gonna lie down. Knees are gonna be bent like a mountaintop, feet flat. Arms are going to be out at your side at about 45 degrees. And then you're going to press the weights up above the chest, kind of meeting them in the middle, giving a nice pectoral squeeze. Slowly drive the arms down to the side, barely tapping the ground with your triceps. And press. Down. Press. Down. Good. 30 seconds here. Abs tight. Keep it going. I'm going to show you with the ball. Do the same thing if you have a ball. It just makes it a tiny bit harder. Walking it out so that your head is resting on the ball. Hips up like a bridge. Same thing. Press over the chest. Slowly back down. Over the chest. Squeezing the pecs. All right. And rest. Good job, you guys. Second exit. Oh, going back to kneeling squats, I should say. Okay. So grabbing that weight, you could have a heavier weight than I have if you want, up to you. On those knees, time starts in three, two, one. Let's go. So one leg forward, opposite leg forward, hip width apart, and back, back. Nice and controlled. Try to alternate which leg steps forward first every time if you can. And again, if you have bad knees and you don't want to keep coming down onto those knees, you can just do those basic weighted front squats. 5 more seconds, okay? And 4, 3, 2, 1. Back to chest press. Grab those two weights. Deep breaths in and out. And 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Press above the chest. Lightly tap the triceps on the ground. Squeeze the pectoral muscles on the top of the move. Halfway there, you guys. Five seconds, four, three, two, one.
Rest. No, Abby, not
right now, okay? Not right now, we're not doing abs. You can do it later when we do abs, okay? And she likes to
need to pick her up when we do lab work and stuff. It's fun.
Going back into our kneeling squats and chest press, last round. Time starts in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Step it forward. Step it forward. Stay low. Back, back. Opposite leg forward. Forward. Back. Back. Opposite leg forward. Forward. Back. Back. Keep it going. 10 seconds. Is this your favorite song, Abby? And 3, 2, 1, rest. Grab that other weight. Last round of chest presses, okay? And time starts in 3, 2, 1. All the way up and down. Squeeze the pecs. Oh, yeah. Doing that little push move. Push. 15 seconds left. Make sure you squeeze. You're not just going through the moves. You are thinking with the muscles you're working, okay? Getting that mind-body connection. And 2, 1, rest. Woo! Good job, you guys. So we made it through station 1 and station 2. We're moving on to station 3 now, all right? So let's see. Station 3, we're gonna be in a kneeling position, but with one leg forward. So our left leg will be forward. We're gonna be working that right shoulder, okay? Keep those hips square, no little hip hikes or anything like that. Hips in line with one another. Tuck those hips under, abs tight, long tailbone. And from here, you're going into one arm overhead press, okay? Just pressing up, pull down into that V, squeezing those lats, pressing right above that shoulder. Good. So only focusing on that right arm for now. If you don't want to be on your knee, you could be standing doing the same thing. You could even add a challenge and balance on the opposite leg. 10 seconds. And 3, 2, 1, rest. Okay, so we work the right side. And now we're going to go into our lateral lunges and reach. And then we'll do the opposite side, okay? So 30 seconds for everything. You're gonna step it to the side. Let's see, step it to the side and reach with the opposite. So left leg will step out to the side into that lateral lunge. Bend that knee, reach with the opposite hand to that inner leg. Pull it in, switch arms, switch sides. So you're switching hands in the middle of the move because you wanna alternate the whole time. So one straight leg, one bent leg. Don't force that stretch, okay? Only go as deep as you can, comfortably, without sacrificing form. About 5 seconds. And then we're gonna go into that left arm, overhead, shoulder press, and rest. All right, back to that kneeling. So opposite leg will be forward. So right leg forward, working the left shoulder, nice and tall here. Find that V with the arm and press, pull, press, pull. Trying to keep those hips in line with one another. Good, arm could be out if you need to, on a hip, whatever's comfortable for you. Again, if you need to, you could come to standing instead. You could balance on the opposite leg while standing. And 3, 2, 1, rest. Good. Going back up to our lateral lunge with a reach. So, going into that lateral lunge, reaching for that inner leg of that bent leg. Switching the weight. Switching hands at the middle of the move, the top of the move. Or you can hold two weights. You can hold two dumbbells. Crazy song, you can dance to see? Oh yeah. She loves to dance and sing. Here we go, 10 seconds more. And rest. Good job. Okay, back down. Right arm this time, left leg forward. Getting that overhead shoulder press in 3, 2, 1, let's go. You are strong, ladies. Don't give up, you guys, okay? We're doing this together. About 8 seconds. My tummy might be a little off, you guys. Sorry about that. And 2, 1, rest. Back up to standing, okay? And get ready for those lateral lunges. Time starts now, lateral lunge and reach. Switch hands at the top of the move. Paint those inner and outer thighs and legs. We're taking it higher, we're going to that next level, right, you guys? We do not want to plateau or go backwards in our where we're at in our fitness right now, you know? We want to keep that ball rolling, moving forward, and rest. Okay, so we got to do the other arm. I know it's an extra round, but we're only doing just the left arm. We're not doing the lateral lunge and reach anymore, okay? So last round for this station. Right leg forward, left side shoulder press, and press, pull, press, pull. Almost there. Abby, make sure you don't block me, okay, honey? Only so everybody can see what we're working on. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, rest. Good job, you guys. Ooh, drop that weight. Hide it if you need to. We are moving on to round 4. So station 4. So we have 5 stations all together, you guys. So we're almost there. So station 4 is happening in just a couple of seconds, about 20 seconds. Hydrate, hydrate. Our next exercises will be burpee to deadlift and in and out bicep curls, okay? So you could use 2 dumbbells if you want for those burpees with the deadlift. That's actually what I recommend, okay? If you have a kettlebell, you can even use that, it's up to you. And just like with those first, the pop squats we did in the first round, I forgot to demonstrate with the kettlebell, but you could pop it with the kettlebell. It makes it a little bit easier. Anyway, back to round 4, okay? Station 4. Grab your 2 weights. Here we go. So you're gonna burpee, option to push up or no push up. Abs tight, hop it forward, drive those. Hips forward, squeezing the booty, okay? Lower the weights back down to your sides. Make sure you're getting a nice squat here when you lower the weights so you're not hurting your back. Hop it back, option to push up, hop it forward. Drive those hips forward, squeezing the booty. Good, 20 seconds left. Again, option to add that push up. And you know, also step it back. Step it in if you need to. Okay, you don't have to always hop, hop. Okay, and rest. So that's your burpee to deadlift. We are super setting it with in and out bicep curls. You could do it standing, kneeling. If you have a BOSU, you could do it kneeling on your BOSU like we do at the gym. All right, up to you. Or you could do single leg. Just to wake up all your stabilizer muscles. All right, palms face out. Time starts now. We're gonna full range of motion curl up. Rotate the arms out to the side. And full range of motion curl out. Keep it going. In, out, In, out. And if you're doing the single leg, just remember what leg you're using. So when you get back to this, you can switch legs. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, rest. Good job. Moving on, going back to our burpees with the deadlift. I'll demonstrate with the kettlebell this time, just in case you have one. Otherwise, get those weights. Time's gonna start in 3, 2, 1, 30 seconds. Hopping it back, hopping it forward, grabbing that kettlebell. Okay, we're halfway there, keep it going. So just a little demo. Oh, also, don't forget if you wanna add that push-up, you could totally beast mode it. Step it back if you need to. You can even drop it to your knees. You wanna do that push-up. And rest. Good job, you guys. Grab two dumbbells for bicep curls. Round two. Deep breaths in and out. And here we go. Full range of motion. Remember, if you're doing that single leg, do the opposite leg you did the first round. Trying to keep those hips square. Squeeze those guns. It's a gun show right now. Shoulder blades should be together, scapula together. Shoulders down and back. Try not to swing or sway, okay? Strong, so strong. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest. One more round of that superset. Burpees to deadlift. Bicep curls, okay? Are you ready? Deep breaths in and out, grab those weights. I like to go heavier for the burpees. Up to you if you do too. And 3, 2, 1. I'll do a few different variations. Single leg if you want, up to you. We even do staggered stance. It's just one leg in front. 8 seconds to go. Good job, sis. I knew you could do it. And 3, 2, 1, rest. Good job, you guys. Woo! Hydrate if you need to. We're moving on to our fifth round, our fifth circuit. 1 second. All right, our fifth station, sorry. Our fifth station, guys. Our next superset is bridge and skull crushers. So you could do your bridge on the ground. You could have your feet up on a Bosu ball, on an exercise ball, on whatever you have, okay? For now, I'm gonna demonstrate from the ground. You could grab a weight if you want to have on your pelvis. Feet are gonna be flat. All right, knees up like a mountaintop. Dumbbell or weight on the pelvis. 30 seconds starts in 3, 2, 1. Lifting up and down, giving a nice glute squeeze. belly button to spine. I need all that booty work. It's all about that squeeze. And if you want to make it harder, you could do one leg instead and just switch after 15 seconds. Okay? 3, 2, 1, rest. Then you're gonna stay down where you are on the mat. We're gonna do skull crushers. So I'm gonna face this way so you can see what my arms are doing. Legs are just gonna be at mountaintop, feet are flat. And you're gonna grab two dumbbells or one. I'll show you both ways. 30-second skull crushers. So you want your arms to be in nice and tight, okay? Not out like this, nice and tight. Nice and close to your body. And you're gonna extend the arms up at an angle, squeezing and allowing them to drop near that skull. Squeeze down. Even though you're laying down, you wanna make sure your shoulders are down, okay? And I'm gonna demonstrate with one dumbbell. So you can hold the dumbbell like this and do the same thing. Arms in so tight. Right in line with those shoulders. Good, it's supposed to be tough. And you're forming that mountaintop kind of with those arms, that elbow. And rest. Woo, so those were your skull crushers. We're gonna go back to that bridge. Again, to make that bridge harder, if you wanted, you could grab a Bosu or a something, anything, a chair. Whatever, and you can put the top of your feet on if you want. All right, get ready. Bridge, time starts now. Lifting the hips, lower. Squeeze the booty, lower. Whatever weight you're using, near that pelvis. Good. Again, you could do one leg at a time if you want. 10 seconds. And 4, 3, 2, 1, rest. Going back to your skull crushers. So whether you're using one or two weights, up to you. All right, here we go. And begin, 30 seconds. Arms are nice and tight. Up and down, just like if you were doing tricep dips. You don't want any wings. Good. Don't forget to squeeze from where that elbow is. About 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. We're moving on, going back to the bridge, our last round of bridge, our last round of skull crushers. So get in that bridge position. And go. Up. And down again. You could do one leg if you want to make it a little harder. Or you can have your feet on something elevated. Okay? But make sure you're getting that squeeze of the glutes. Perfect. 10 seconds. And 4, 3, 2, 1. Grab your weights for your skull crushers, your final round of skull crushers. And then we have our final station. I know I said 5 in the beginning, but I see that we have more time, so I'm adding a 6th station, okay? All right, skull crushers. 30 seconds starts now. Elbows up. Nice flat back. Try to keep that lower back on the mat all times. Don't let it arch, okay? If your weight, if you're using only one dumbbell and it's not hard enough, or it feels light towards the end of your reps, use two, okay? My rule of thumb is on a level, or on a scale of 1 to 10. Huh? Yeah, uh-huh. Sorry, that's a daughter. Hold on, I'll get back to what I was saying in a second. And 5 seconds left. 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest.
All right, what I was saying was on a scale from 1 to 10, 10 being the hardest, 1 being the easiest, you want your last few reps to be between a 7 and a 10, okay? If your goal is to get strength or hypertrophy, make sure you're using enough weight. All right, come here. My daughter wants a snack. You guys know how that is. You mamas know how that is. Nice, healthy granola that has veggies in it. Granola minis. All right, here we go. All right, we're gonna do one more station. Are you ready? Our next superset, we're gonna do reverse lunge with the pass through, okay? Time starts now. Legs hip width apart, and you're gonna step back into that reverse lunge. Once you're down, once you have that knee lowered, pass that weight through. Switch legs, pass that weight through. All right, find your balance first. Toes are straight ahead. Squeeze that booty as you step back. 10 seconds left right here. And 3, 2, 1, rest. Grab your other weight and get ready. We're gonna do front and lateral raises for shoulders. In 2, 1, 30 seconds. Forward, palms down to the side. Palms down, forward, palms down, to the side. Good, keep it going. You're gonna get through this. I don't know if you can hear the music. Couple more seconds, and rest. I'm gonna grab my lighter weights real quick. All right, going back to that pass-through. Reverse lunge with pass-through. Legs hip width apart, and here we go. Step it back. Oops. From the inside. From the inside. Keep it going. Stay nice and tall with that upper body, okay? Try not to lean forward. Posture. Tall. That's something we should practice all the time. And if you need this to be easier, you could just eliminate the weight or the pass through and just hold the weight at your chest or something. And rest. Good. Grab those dumbbells for your shoulders, your front and lateral raises. Are you ready? Here we go. Front. Lateral. Only coming up to shoulder height. Try not to go higher than your shoulders. And 3, 2, 1, rest. Our last round, okay, before we hit up our finisher. So grab your weight for your reverse lunge and pass through. Time starts in 3, 2, 1. Step it back, pass it through from that inside. Squeeze the booty as you step back. Find your balance first, you guys. Stay tall with that upper body. Almost there. All right. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest. Grab those shoulder weights. Last round. All right. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Forward,
down, to the side, down. Only to shoulder height. I'm all watching the screen. I'm checking my form, you guys. This is my mirror right now. You could be in staggered stance if you need to. I just realized I just did that on my own. 3, 2, 1, rest. You did it. Okay, so you made it through your stations. When I showed you, well, when I post the workout, I'll make sure to add that 6th station that I wasn't planning on. Okay, but we're gonna do a finisher right now. I'm going to grab the iPad and change my music real quick. So I said it on one of the other videos, but if you have Spotify or iTunes, you can usually find Tabata music, Tabata workout music on there. And that's what I like to do so I don't have to keep checking my watch for Tabata timing, like every 20 or 10 seconds. Okay, so we're gonna do 4 exercises for our finisher. Okay, Sissy, go ahead. We're doing 4 exercises for our finisher. It's all pretty much abs. You can grab a weight if you want. And we're gonna start. So I'm gonna just do it all with you, so be ready. The first exercise is running man, okay? So be ready for that. All right. Here we go. Are you ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Hands underneath your shoulders. You're either popping it out, tapping it out, nice flat tabletop back, or you guys know the standing one. All right, whatever works for you. We will be coming back to this shortly. 1, rest. Penguins are next. Take a seat, lie down. We're gonna be going side to side, so get ready. 2, 1, let's go. Reach for those ankles. Penguins. Lift that head up off the ground in a nice little hover. Hitting up those obliques. 4, 3, 2, 1, rest. Coming up for Russian twists. Grab a weight if you can. It's close by. And you're going hip to hip or further back, up to you. You can drive that bus, big wheel if you want. Heels can be down if you need to, or up to make it harder. 2, 1, rest. Our last one is toe touches. We're gonna be going through this one more round after these. So feet are gonna be up in the sky, legs long, point the toes to your nose. Weight in your hand, you could reach, 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 and reach. You don't want your legs to come in like this. You want to keep them straight up to the sky as you reach. If it's too hard with the weight, you could drop the weight and do the same thing. Reaching for those ankles or toes. And rest. So we're going to repeat those 4. This is it, you guys. Getting ready for running man. All right. 2, 1, here we go. Get those knees in towards your chest, belly button to spine. You can power through it. Tap, tap, or you know what to do. You know what to do, kayak ladies. 2, 1, rest. Penguins coming up. 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Whittle. And you don't have to wait for that 10 seconds to rest. You could go right to the next exercise if you want, okay? Up to you. Rest. Russian twist coming up. Grab that weight. These are quick transitions. Last 40 seconds of work, you guys. And go. Heels down if you need to. Make sure you're leaning back. Chest out. Good. Last one. Toe touches. Remember, try not to bring the legs in like this. Keep them stacked over those hips. And reach. 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 Point those toes toward your nose. Reach. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 2, 1.
Rest. You guys made it. Awesome work. Thank you guys for joining me for lift. Don't give up. Keep pushing through. You got to keep that ball rolling. That's all there is to it. Okay, ladies? Nice work. Woo! Give yourself a pat on the back. Stretch those triceps. Give yourself a pat on the back. Good job. I'm doing it at home. Woo! All right. See you later.